Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Before we get started with this video today, I'd like to let you know that I am doing a giveaway for a Logitech G915 Lightspeed wireless keyboard, courtesy of my partners over at LogitechG. If you'd like to take a look at that giveaway, I'll put a link in the description below. That will take you over to my Twitter, X, whatever you want to call it nowadays, where you can retweet and enter in order to win that awesome keyboard. Big thank you to LogitechG for allowing me to do that. Let's go ahead and get right into it, because we did get a big update today for Modern Warfare 3, which included some sweeping changes for the ranked playlist that completely disables the usage of sniper rifles. And on top of that, we also had a field upgrade completely disabled permanently. And I want to start with that conversation because I find it kind of amusing. And I'm going to be honest, I don't think we've ever had a field upgrade permanently disabled ever in multiplayer multiple seasons into the game's life. So let's go ahead and see what Sledgehammer had to say. The field upgrade that was removed is the loadout drop. And they said, due to limited use and often being utilized to reach exploitable locations, the loadout drop is no longer available in multiplayer. The updates page even says it's been permanently disabled in multiplayer. Until this item is removed from the game, players who have it equipped will instead spawn with an ammo box. This is very important information. And I gotta tell you what, this is kind of amusing to me because back in the original MW2, way back in the day, the one thing that was plaguing that game that never got a fix was one-man army. One-man army allowed you to have infinite noob tubes and combined with certain perks allowed you to be a force to be reckoned with. It was easy tactical nukes game after game if you really wanted to go that route with noob tubes and one-man army. The loadout drop was essentially OMA for 2023 and 2024. It's just, you know, things are more balanced now, so noob tubes kind of suck ass. There aren't any perks that actually make explosions do more damage like they did in the past. You know, the thing is, I think it just comes down to the exploitable locations, but I do find it kind of funny that we had our OMA of the MW2 remaster, which is what I look at as MW3. The MW2 remaster finally had its OMA removed, which is what this is, essentially. So that's just kind of amusing to me. You know, in the past, all we ever wanted was noob tubes not to replenish, and they were never able to make that happen. So, you know, this doesn't really bother me. I never used the loadout drop. I never really saw a specific use for it personally, especially in a world of an ammo box. The ammo box essentially does the same exact thing, minus being able to switch your class without needing to respawn. I think that was the biggest benefit. But like Sledgehammer says, there were more players using it to reach exploitable locations. And the first thing that comes to mind is terminal. I think I remember people using this to get up and out of terminal. Trick shotters, snipers, and things like that. That didn't really bother me when people got on top of terminal. That's just kind of like par for the course when it comes to Call of Duty. The only time things like that really frustrate me is when players are able to get up and over behind a wall that's completely see-through. You can't damage them, but they can damage you type of situation. That's when it bugs me. If someone's out in the open on top of terminal and you could just shoot them where you're at in the map, not a big deal for me personally, but I kind of understand why this happened. So that has been disabled. The loadout drop is no longer available. They're going to be replacing it with an ammo box if you have it currently set up to your classes and were one of those players that utilized it. And if you were one of those players that utilized it, I'd really like to know what your thought process is about it down below in the comments section. I never really saw a use for it. If there was a specific use that you had, let me know. The only thing that I can really think of in my head, at least how I would utilize it, is say I'm playing on a map like Derail or High Rise, where sniper is really important at the beginning of a round. And then say I went on a 5 or 6 kill streak, I want to continue that streak. Then I hurry up and switch over to an AR setup, or I switch over to something that's going to take that fight into the middle of the map, the bridge area on Derail, or, you know, the underground section on High Rise. Snipers aren't going to be, you know, best suited for close quarters combat. So yeah, you kind of understand it there. If you had any other usage, I'd like to know about in the comments section below. But otherwise, that is the permanently disabled field upgrade. I wonder if this is going to be the norm moving forward. Imagine in the past if we had things like this for the original MW2. Hey, we're just going to, you know, disable OMA until we can fix it. Or hey, we're going to disable tactical insurgents because there's too many people boosting. And I don't know, man. It would have been a much different time in our lives if they did it like that. So the other thing that I wanted to talk about, because I do find it a little bit amusing, is the snipers being restricted in Modern Warfare 3 multiplayer ranked play. And as you would imagine, people are not very happy about this, especially because this is one of those situations where If you're a player and you enjoy a certain playstyle and you're good at it, especially in the ranked scenario, you don't want to have your things messed with from people outside of your control. And the thing about the CDL is it's ever-changing, right? Players will have their GAs on certain things that should be banned, and that's just kind of agreed upon between the pro players. And with this new iteration of ranked play that we've been seeing for the past few years, it's been on par with what the pro players have been agreeing with each other. So essentially what the pros are dealing with, that's what the players have to deal with. And I understand why that could be frustrating, because obviously it's not like people in the ranked mode are playing for real money like the real pro players are. But that's the experience that you're basically signing up for when you play this generation of ranked play, because... And you gotta admit it to them. You gotta admit to the folks over at the CDL. They've been in really good contact with the folks that are handling the ranked play at Treyarch. They're keeping it toe-to-toe with everything that's been happening this year. And the updates have been phenomenal for that reason. So this is the closest thing that you can play to being a pro at this point. And I think that even if it's really, really annoying when one of your favorite weapons gets GA'd or certain attachments can't be used or certain perks or streaks or whatever, it is really important to mention that this mode means a lot for a lot of players. And if you can actually work your way up to the top of the leaderboard, you will be noticed by people like teams and other players, and you will be noticed and maybe even scouted out to be recruited to these teams. And that's just how close this ranked play is anymore with the CDL. So as annoying as it is, if you really take this mode seriously, if you really do put in the effort and the work to grind your way up to the top of the leaderboards, to be with the best of the best, to be number one in the world, you will be recognized. And the best part about this is you don't need a social media footprint. You don't need to have a YouTube channel. You don't need to have a Twitter or whatever the case may be. You don't have to have anything online. You can just make it known by your skill and where you're at on that leaderboard. And that could potentially blossom into something else in the future, like being scouted by an actual CDL team or being brought onto a team or, you know, consulting or whatever, coaching. Endless opportunities, and that's the point that I'm trying to make. So as corny as it is, as bullshit as it is for a lot of people that like to use snipers, I'm not a pro player. I don't play the ranked mode, but that's kind of my perspective on the entire situation. I'd like to know what you think about it in the comment section below, but I think that Treyarch, so far alongside with the CDL, they've been doing a pretty awesome job keeping toe-to-toe with what changes have been happening on the fly, like we see year after year. And I really can't fault them for that. They're doing a really good job. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Once again, check out that giveaway for the Logitech G915 Lightspeed Wireless Keyboard down below in the description. And if you guys enjoyed this one, drop a like, subscribe for more, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.